Poland, September 1939. The German foe begins its ruthless march of conquest and sets the stage for World War II. Poland's 34 million inhabitants, crushed, scattered, and enslaved. Tens of thousands of square miles of territory shrink before the movement of lightning-armored columns. Poland and the world learn the meaning of a grim new word, Blitzkrieg. Here is shown the initiation of that phase of modern warfare. These pictures of the preparation for attack, and later the actual combat, were all made by German frontline cameramen. Therefore, they stress Nazi superiority. Success is unimpeded as Hitler's divisions move against outnumbered Polish defenders. Later, on other world battlefronts, the Allies are to destroy the myth of the invincibility of the Nazi armies. But this is Hitler at the peak of his armed might, and the record of a nation overrun in just days is of military as well as historical importance. The spark is set off in the free city of Danzig. Nazi secret agents had long plotted the revolt against law and order. Germany called it liberation. The world knew that Danzig represented the ignition of the European powder keg, the excuse for Hitler's hordes to begin their destructive campaign of conquest. Here is the historic last stand of Danzig's loyal defenders. They're entrenched in the city's post office and under repeated fire of Nazi-trained militiamen. Taking cover behind an advancing tank, the attackers move in. Gasoline is sprayed on the building, and its doom is sealed. On September 1st, Danzig is incorporated into the Reich, and all Europe is aflame. World War II is a reality. Nazi regulars move up. The Germans brazenly call it counterattack with pursuit. The civilized world knows it as the unleashing of unheard-of military might. With little to stand in their way, the Nazi divisions roar across the Polish countryside and reveal for the first time the machines and weapons that are to terrorize a freedom-loving people. Military observers see the Nazi lightning warfare as setting the style for modern battle. Only a well-devised counter-blitz can stem the flanking and pincer movements of the wily Germans. The motorcycles bring up machine gunners for the opening of the attack. Camouflage is used to best advantage. Crushing up of troops for more blitz attacks. The German strategy is to isolate Polish forces as quickly as possible. So the Nazi columns move according to prearranged schedule. 30 to 37 miles per day is the German claim. A strategic bridge across the Vistula River has been blown up by retreating Polish soldiers. But in their haste, they were unable to ensure its complete destruction. The enemy will be delayed, but temporary repair is not impossible for skilled mechanics to accomplish in fast time, as Hitler hurled at the universe. Arrogant, well-trained, the Nazis marched through Warsaw's streets. The world was permitted to view this display of military pomp and expected to bow before Germany's might. But the events of years following Poland's setback were to tell another story. The Allies are fighting to prove that these goose-stepping legions are not supermen, that the events of September 1939 shall never happen again. the siege of Warsaw. The big attack begins 31 miles outside the capital. Shells are dropped into Warsaw without let-up as day by day the Nazis forge a tighter ring of steel around the almost helpless city. Fires in the city send up huge clouds of smoke. Polish defenders come up to surrender their arms. Germans claim sizable quantities of guns and ammunition taken throughout the country. There was no time for the Poles to destroy their weapons. So quickly did the Nazis move in and dominate each position.